Ceramics are ordinarily brittle. However, we have developed special ceramics that can heal their own cracks with the aid of heat in less than a minute. Of course, the material retains its strength. The healing process requires heating at 1,000 degrees centigrade. We at NIMS envision using it in aircraft components. Self-healing ceramics were invented in 1995 in Japan. They consist mainly of alumina and are doped with silicon carbide as a healing agent. However, the mechanism responsible remained unknown for more than 20 years, and it must be heated to 1,000 degrees centigrade for 1,000 hours to heal. The healing time had to be reduced in order for these ceramics to be put into practical use. Dr. Toshio Osada decided to devote himself to elucidating the healing mechanism. He found a clue in the healing process of bones, which are similarly hard and breakable. When a bone breaks, blood fills the crack and promotes the deposition of temporary soft bone, which eventually heals the bone to its original strength. Thus, we can likewise expect a liquid-like substance to play an important role in the healing process of self-healing ceramics. He began a detailed investigation of the self-healing process with the state-of-the-art analytical instruments at NIMS. Finally, he succeeded in taking a very interesting photograph. He discovered that a liquid-like substance was filling the cracks. It turns out that this liquid filling of the cracks is the first stage of the healing process. However, both alumina and silicon carbide have high melting points, preventing them from melting at 1,000 degrees centigrade. How was the liquid-like substance generated? This photograph provides the answer. The liquid-like substance is composed of mullite, not silicon carbide. This is generated by the reaction between silicon dioxide, produced when silicon carbide oxidizes, and alumina, an unexpected participant in the healing process. Dr. Osada had successfully elucidated the healing mechanism. As soon as a crack appears, oxygen gas flows in, reacting with silicon carbide to form silicon dioxide. Then silicon dioxide then reacts with alumina to form a liquid-like substance called a supercooled melt, which fills the crack. Moreover, this supercooled melt crystallizes immediately, repairing the crack firmly and completely. This is exactly the same mechanism behind the recovery of living bones. Next, Dr. Osada looked for ways to speed up the healing process. He narrowed the target to manganese oxide, because his calculations predicted that it would help generate a supercooled melt at a lower temperature. He created an ingenious arrangement of manganese oxide, inspired again by the bone fracture healing process. Wherever a crack appears in a living bone, blood fills it immediately, triggering the healing process. A crack in ceramic appears along the boundaries of alumina crystals. If manganese oxide can be distributed throughout the alumina crystal boundaries across a ceramic, it should promote a healing reaction. He succeeded in creating a manganese 3D network in this sample and confirmed the distribution of elements within it. The green area along the grain boundaries contains manganese oxide. This is an ideal 3D network for the self-healing of cracks. Let's watch the initial stage of the healing process in a sample with artificial cracks. After only 1 minute of heating at 1,000 degrees centigrade, we can see some liquid appearing in the cracks. These healed cracks are strong enough to endure this fracture test. It's broken. Let's examine the healed cracks. The fracture occurred in a different location than the healed cracks. Usually a fracture spreads along a crack like this. Thus, this healing process also completely restores the material to its original strength. Dr. Osada thinks that this makes it promising for use in lightweight aircraft engine turbine blades. I really hope that it can be used in jet engines. During flight, small cracks could heal by themselves. 1 minute healing is almost instantaneous given the length of a typical flight. Mid-flight self-repair would no longer be just a dream.